everybody enjoying the freestyle to music. But now, on this big stage, lots of pressure. And there's the bell, and the voice from the crowd, you probably heard it. Come on, Amy. Come on, Amy.
Yes, and she did very well yesterday. She scored 69%. So it was her Olympia debut. So she's equipped herself really well and can probably score better again today. He is a massive horse, this 17-2. But she does say of him that he's very generous and very given, and he makes her life a little bit easier than some horses.
Yes, a Swedish warm blood by Allselt's Briar. The 13-year-old, and on board the 32-year-old.
Amy's been riding this horse now for some 5 years, so they've cemented their partnership really well, owned by her mother. He's now 13.
Here's another semi-rhetorical question. At what age would you buy a horse if you wanted to become number one dressage rider? Would you find something that's untried, unspoiled? Or would you wait and see what it's got to show you before leaping in?
Well, that's a difficult question. I'm sure lots of these riders ponder it. Firstly, there will be some budget to consider. Made dressage horses such as Moreland's Totalis, hugely expensive, so way out of most people's league to buy that ready-made horse. But you know, that's one extreme. The other extreme is a very young horse, an unbroken horse, or something that's a foal even. But of course, that takes time to produce, and you never know quite what you're going to end up with. So, like all of these equestrian disciplines, it's a huge lottery. And if you get a horse that comes good age, you know, 8, 9, 10, then you're very lucky.
As for Amy Stovolts, make it a four-year-old. No particular type necessarily. It's got to have a good temperament. And of course, movement that can appear across the board, but it could be an Andalusian, an Oldenburg, Holstein.
Yes, I think the actual breeding is less important these days than how the horse actually presents himself and is able to perform. It's taken some time for the dressage world to accept the pure Andalusian horses. They're slightly unconventional in the world of dressage, but they are creeping into the sport a bit. Spanish, of course, doing better and better on those horses. Amy riding a really nice test so far. The horse certainly is very generous. He's responding really well to her. He's obedient, concentrating and trying. Not the neatest pirouette that we've seen so far this evening.
Still the score to beat is 73.75. Got the score in for the Finnish rider, Michaela Lindt. A Mas Guapo, 73.1 that. Second place for her.
So very even one time tempis across to the side of the arena. He does look very level-headed, this horse. Our half pass to the right. That time, a circle was better. Extending the canter across the diagonal, not as brave as we've seen some, but she didn't lose too many marks by being not too brave, because the transition back down was really good.
Coming towards the end of her performance yesterday in the Grand Prix was fifth. Amy Stovold has a livery and training centre based at Cowfold in West Sussex. And there we are. Nicely done. Very nice. She's been on the world-class program since 2008 and is currently working with a dozen horses, bringing them on. Her long-term aim is to get involved in the Olympics for Great Britain. But another big dream of hers was to appear at Olympia. She's done it for the very first time. It was fine yesterday. Could it be even finer now in the Kerr?
Should we give them one more round of applause? Yes, she rode a very good test. She should be delighted with that.